Getting this engine light that keeps popping up and telling me I have a lean bank number one, lean bank number two. Two quotes found. Yeah, one, two. If you guys can see that. If any of you guys know or have experienced that problem, I've changed the fuel filter. I've gone and made sure, you know, there's no air leaks anywhere. To the best of my ability, I've done not a smoke test, but kind of an old-fashioned way that guys would do it is spray starter fluid, you know, around your intake, just and really carefully. Obviously, you don't want to just because one, it's very flammable, and two, it's really flammable, and I'm not, you know, getting any increase RPMs when I do that. Because that code could be a leaky intake. And then there's multiple sensors that it could possibly be. Fortunately, the shops in Hope here are just not as good as they used to. And I kind of find shops now are just more of a switch apart, and if it works, it works. You know, the whole diagnosing is just kind of out the window now. So it's getting expensive just switching all these random parts, but it's only been coming on more because of the cold, so I don't know if that, you know, maybe might help tell you something, but if you know, leave a comment below. So today we have to head over to Abbotsford. That's two towns over from our little village of Hope, British Columbia, and I thought today would be a good day to take you guys into Princess Auto. I believe in the US that's called Harbor Freight. So basically it's the exact same store. It's a discount store for tools and pretty much everything under the sun. And just go in there and kind of show you guys some of the products and if going to Princess Auto is a good place to buy off-roading gear and overlanding gear. And we have purchased a couple. Oh, hey there. Just kind of barge right in there. I've gone in there and bought a few items before. A few of them I've had good luck with, and then some of them and not so good. So I'll kind of point out which ones have been good and which ones haven't been. You guys can determine if Princess Auto is a good spot to pick up that stuff. On the road here, and a fairly big one. That's how blistery it is over here. Holy cow. That's pretty crazy. So we're in the camping overlanding section. This is one of the products we have. This is an overlanding shower from Northridge. Really good brand. This is another one of their products, the camp shower. That's it right there. Almost bought that last year when it was on sale, but didn't. This is another one of their products, Northridge and truck tent. This one's kind of cool because it comes with like an awning out back too. Or you can just get the awning at the back of your car there. An SUV tent. That's going for $429. You got your single burner stove for $29. And a dual for $54. Bat wing awning. This is actually something that I do want. This is just for the side walls, $3.99. Have a recovery rope here. That's expensive, I think. $549, but that's huge. That's in 2-inch. $299. And then just your standard straps. You have quite a few just lights to select from. And pretty reasonable too. You know, 33, 32, 16, 22 for these square ones. Leveling lift kits, that's for a Dodge Ram, a Jeep, a Chevy, Ford, and Toyota. Again, for $139. All leveling lift kits, that's actually a pretty darn good deal. For light bars, emergency lights. All their winches, that's a 10,000 pound for $629. Their power fist, which one's that? 12,000 pounds. That one for $599. It's pretty good. They have ATV ones too. Soft shackle for $34. Another a metal shackle there for $21. That's really good. All the cabling for the winch roller bars there, $59. Winch mounting plate for $99. Traction boards here for $99. Another product from Northridge. Lighting switches and stuff for wiring. That's pretty cool. All the different accessories, lots of lighting stuff. Got your color LEDs, marker lights, light covers, 1,000 watt power converter. All right, back in the truck. So yeah, there's just a quick tour of Princess Auto. There's so much there, you know. It's not just what I showed you. There's tools and paint supplies, tons of storage containers. There's so much there, and their prices are really good too. Would I recommend coming to Princess Auto to buy, you know, gear for your truck, your SUV? Yeah, I probably would, especially if you know you find yourself in a bind, and or you just don't want to wait, you know, for that Amazon truck. You just want to go out and buy something, be able to actually look at it yourself and touch it and feel it. Their products that we've had, they're Northridge. They seem like the good quality. Unfortunately, they didn't have any rooftop tents there. If I can find it online, I'll post it right here. So yeah, again, it gives you the opportunity to kind of go out and see what's there. And it's a great little store. So I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Consider sharing it with your friends and family, and yeah, give Princess Auto a try. At least you can go there, kind of see what they have, compare it to what's online. It's almost like an Amazon you can go to, because a lot of the prices are definitely pretty comparable to Amazon. So give it a shot. My name's Adam. You're watching an Adventure Overland. Take care.